The giant sea isopod. At first glance, it might trigger fascination with its size and strange alien details. Or it might awaken something darker, bringing your worst nightmares to life. It's related to pill bugs, lychia, and spermatidae. But today, we're focusing on the king of them all, Bathynomus giganteus, the largest species of giant isopod ever discovered. We'll take you from its first discovery to the strange secrets still hiding beneath its shell. So let's dive really deep into the hadal zone, where some of these giants thrive at crushing pressures and freezing temperatures. Because once you learn what they're capable of, you'll never look at the sea bug the same way again. Fact number one, the first giant isopod was pulled from a fishing net in 1879, off the coast of Mexico. French zoologist Alphonse Milne Edwards said it was one of the most unusual animals he'd ever studied. Over 140 years later, we still agree. It had an armored body like a beetle, legs like a lobster, and strange feathered gills protected under shell plates, designed to breathe in near-freezing, low-oxygen water. It looked like it belonged in a fossil bed, not a fishing net. Fact number two. While most isopods are fingernail-sized, Bathynomus giganteus can grow nearly the size of a house cat, due to deep-sea gigantism, a phenomenon where animals grow exceptionally large to survive the harsh deep-sea environment with cold temperatures, scarce food, and extreme pressure. Recent endocrinological studies have revealed that this remarkable growth is precisely controlled by insulin and thyroid hormones, which regulate their metabolism, cell growth, and energy efficiency. These hormonal systems are essentially hardwired to help them survive in extreme conditions, explaining how they grow slower, live longer, and reach such massive sizes compared to their shallow water relatives. Fact number three, when food finally hits the deep sea, like a fish or whale carcass, giant isopods don't nibble. They gorge, swelling their bodies until they can barely crawl. In captivity, some have eaten so much they look like they're about to burst. In the wild, a few were even found with plastic in their stomach. Why so intense? Because meals are rare. So nature equipped them with two internal food vaults, a midgut gland and a fat body that store fat and protein for the long haul. It's like having a personal deep-sea fridge and stuffing it in one sitting. In the deep, it's feast hard or risk starving. Fact number four. Female isopods carry their eggs in a brood pouch, kind of like a kangaroo. These flaps, called oestagitus, create a protective space under the body. The eggs are some of the largest among marine invertebrates, but scientists rarely see brooding females. They probably hide deep, in silence, until the young hatch. Which makes sense. Parenting at the bottom of the sea is serious business. Fact number five. In 2009, a male giant isopod arrived at Toba Aquarium in Japan. He ate one meal, just one. Then for 5 whole years, he stopped eating completely. He would touch food, rub his face on it, then just walk away. Finally, in 2014, he died, having never eaten again. The aquarium called it a hunger strike. The other isopods were eating fine. No one knows exactly why he stopped, but in a way, it proves how far these creatures can stretch their biology. They're the deep sea's ultimate survivors, even if it sometimes costs them everything. Fact number 6. A related species, the Antarctic giant isopod, Glyptonotus antarcticus, was tested for heat tolerance. The result? Not great. After just a few hours at slightly warmer temperatures, juvenile isopods showed no clear stress response. Their genes basically panicked. Their cells couldn't adjust, their systems shut down, and key proteins for survival were suppressed. This suggests that as oceans warm, some isopods may struggle to survive. Giant isopods are armored, ancient, and strangely adorable. They breathe through gill trees, cradle giant eggs like ocean marsupials, store energy like camels, and can survive years without a single bite of food. They're part scavenger, part survivor, part mystery, and 100% weird. And we're still just scratching the surface. Want more deep sea weirdness? Hit subscribe. There's a whole alien world waiting below.